welcome to this CineRender Surface Material Series. My name is Carsten MD from ASM TechBase. Please subscribe to my channel and make sure you ring the bell option here like all, so you get all the latest video notifications, all my tutorial, so you won't miss out on anything. And one more thing, on my website, join the ASM TechBase email list for newsletters and future updates. In part 8 of this CineRender Surface Material series, we're looking at the channel Alpha and the channel Glow. Let's start with the Alpha channel. I've got very simple setup here again. I applied the blue colors here and I applied the blue colors there, which is just simply called ASM TechBase Alpha. So go in here and we open our settings, go to the CineRender engine, and you can see it is a simple color for now. The first step we do is we add now an alpha channel. So you click here, and what I want to show you first is how to do a wire fence. For this I got my Photoshop file open, I use a wire fence image, and you can see the background is white, and as alpha channel I sort of invert this and the background is black and the actual wire fence, it's just white. All right, let's get back to our ARCHICAD. I will add this now here and we add this image. I did load this in my embedded library, so I can just choose the wire fence alpha and we add this here. All right, you can see what happens now. It takes out anything that is black. Let's just click OK and we do a render. Okay, as you can see, it nicely took everything out that's black. Color at the moment still is bluish color. And you can see that the image size is too big for our fence. So let's get back into our settings here. And the first thing I want to do is the size. The moment it's 1000 by 1000, it all depends on the image. This is actually quite a small image. If I have a look here, it's only 470 by 440, so it's quite small. So, you know, you have to work this out depending on what type of image or what size of image you use. So let me reduce this. Let's go down to 250. Okay, there you go. And then we zoom in a little bit, go to our 3D and let's zoom in, move this a bit, there we go, and we render this up again. Okay, this looks much better already. The size, again, you want a bit smaller, make it smaller, that's fine. The realism is not there yet because we only have a color. So add now our fence image to the color channel. We go here and we got none image, and from my embedded library I added the fence image. I showed you before, white background, and actually the fence image itself is like from a photo. So I hit OK. The size is automatically the same as I put in here, and let's render this up now. Okay, this looks already much better. Obviously with the background I've got here, I've got a bit of a gray floor, so you're losing the fence here, and I've got a brick background, which is so usually not very what you got. So usually you got probably grass down here, you got some trees at the back, another background or whatever. But I like to show you, if I zoom in, that it's actually quite nice. So if you zoom in quite close, and let's go maybe a bit up so you can really see the fence, because we're using an image, it's actually quite a good quality of the fence in regards to realism. As you can see, that looks pretty good actually. You know, see, you wouldn't want to model this. There's no point modeling this because that looks pretty good. Now, before we go further, it is very important you have a look at the fence itself, you know, the sort of wall. I used I just used a very simple cube and made it quite thin. You see, for you gotta have a quite, in this case with the fence, wire fence, you have to have it very small. Let's make it 50 just to show you what happens, you know. So if I go now in 3D and I would render this up, let's go back a little bit and we render this up again. This looks a bit funny, don't like stuff like that, so let's make it 48. All right, and we render this up and you see what happens now. Oh yeah, I can stop the render here. As you can see already, what happens now, it applies the alpha channel twice, obviously, you know, on one surface closer to the camera and on the other surface sort of further away of the camera, sorry, on the side of that flat long high cube. So that's why, and that doesn't work, you can see. So that's why if you do stuff like this with alpha channel, very careful, make sure this is thin enough. So what I had there first, I had 4, that worked pretty well. Now the next bit is I like to show you with the alpha channel. Obviously this has been now just a normal image and an alpha image. You can always use other stuff. Let's just take there that image away, none, and I go here and I say none. So as with all the other channels I showed you before, I could obviously add other things. Procedure last example, let's go to tiles. Okay, I make this a bit bigger so you can see what I mean. Go back to 1000. There you go. It's actually quite a good example. So if I go now to my 3D and I render this up. Okay, while this is rendering, I explain what happens. It obviously then takes again, it only shows you what is not black. Okay, anything in black, it will just disappear. So let's stop this here, go back, and we go to our alpha, and there you go. So the ground color, which is quite thick at the moment, you can see it's black, totally gone. Then you got the tile color red, that is there, it's a little bit transparent, and you got another tile color here and tile color 3. So again, if you then change this, it will be more or less transparent. And you can do that with other stuff too. If I go back here, I could even use as example, I could use like marble. Don't have to render this up, but you can see again, it sort of shows anything that's really black. It will not render, and the white, it will render. Okay, let's have a look at the other options we got here. For now, I did delete both images again, and I want to show you why. Because if I add, as example, an image as a TIFF file which already has an alpha channel in, I show you what happens. Actually, go to the alpha channel first. I add this image, go here, and this time I choose a TIFF image, not a JPEG. And this TIFF image has actually the alpha channel embedded. You can't see this here, I'll show you in a moment in Photoshop. So I add this and you can see it takes it out. Let's have a look in Photoshop how that looks. This is the TIFF image and you got an alpha channel here. If I select this, see the red one, that's my alpha channel here. So that's all just one image, so you don't need then to have a wireframe JPEG and a wireframe alpha. I use a lot both of the images here, but there's sometimes you get images that have this embedded and then you can use it this way. So you put it in here, alpha, it's already taking it out and you can see it's blue because we haven't added a texture and a color. So you have to add this here too. Let's do this here. We can use the same one again as a TIFF file. And then you get your wireframes, different color. And in here, to make it look better, you gotta click image alpha. See, it looks much stronger. And you render it out. So that's the two options you have in using image alpha. Great. I think that's all I can tell you about this alpha channel. Let's move on to the next channel, which is the glow channel. Okay, the glow channel, for you that watched part number 3, where I explained the luminance channel, this is the model I used. So the difference is actually quite simple. Let's open the settings I've got here. Actually, just quickly, I did render one up for you. So that's the render at the moment. I use the Lumens channel and you can see they're glowing and you can see it's a low quality, but you can see there's some light going on to the wooden floor and on the bricks. So if I now go and change this, so instead of using the luminance channel, I want to use the glow. Okay, so add glow, so I click glow there and I actually have to now apply this to something. So I changed from here to another layer combination which I called export text. That's just normal 3D text. This 3D text has applied the glow channel surface. As you saw, as soon as I clicked the glow here, it actually starts glowing the surface. Let's just do nothing but this. I click OK and let's render this up. Okay, as you can see, the main difference right from the start is the following. This is obviously glowing a lot more and it does give some lights, as I said, you know, spreading on the bricks and the floor. If I go back here, it's not really glowing, it's not really light, nothing goes onto the bricks, and that's because I haven't really changed any of the settings, the glow settings. So let's change the glow settings now. Go in here, go to glow, and let's just do the outer strength for a start at 500. You see it's changing here, and we just render this up again. As you can see, nothing really has changed. Let's stop this here. There are a couple of reasons that's not glowing at the moment. First thing is you have to check if the setting is on that you actually do render the glow. Okay, it's under here. You go effects, down here lens and filters. You have to tick object glow. So I ticked that and it still didn't do anything. So that's all good. Let's go back into our settings of the color. So I was here, we put 500 in, even though it looks quite nice here, it didn't do much. And that has to do it because I use the surface color here. So that on additional, you have to go back here and you have to increase the brightness. So let's just double this and we'll see what happens. All right, so double this and we render again. There you go, it's starting to glow quite nicely actually. Okay, as you can see now, quite nicely, it's already started to glow very nice, but the outer glow is way too big. So let's go back in here. You saw that I put that from, I think I put it on 500, yeah, the outer strength. So it's way too big, okay? It was on 100, so let's go back to 100. I just wanted to go this way because a lot of times, even when I started using CineRender, I did exactly this. I went to glow, put this in here, put it up, I turned on glow, I rendered up, said, oh, this is not working at all. So I thought I'd show you the way you can then see where you know, why it doesn't work. So let's go back to the color. So I have this 200 doubled, that's fine. And let's go back to 100 and we render up. So the 100 is really just the glow effect. It's almost like a post-production effect you create in Photoshop. It does not give you any more light in your scene, in your ARCHICAD scene. Yeah, it's, you can only see a little bit now. It's not very strong at all, but it's also quite big, you know? So let's have a look if we can show this different. Yeah, here, see the radius, it's way too large. So let's put this down to 100 and we maybe add a little bit more strength again to 200 and give it another go. There you go. So the radius is much smaller and that's the glow effect. Like I said, you can see it really added on at the end of the render, almost like on top. Just like I said, just like in Photoshop. Let's go back in here. So the radius is much smaller. I can see around, if you look at this, I can make it even a bit smaller. Let's do the radius at 33, so 1/3 of 100. Outer strength 200. Let's put this on 150. And we do this again. There you go. So I can keep obviously changing my settings and you get different results, but I think this is enough for you to understand what it does. The main thing really is it's not creating any extra light in your scene. Okay, that's the totally difference to the luminance channel. This also won't show up in reflection. If I had a glass here, which I have, but I haven't shown reflection, so if I reflect this font, it will not reflect the glow in here. If you want to do this, you have to use the luminance channel. Great, this was part 8 of the series, alpha channel and glow channel. The next part, number 9, will be the displacement channel and grass. I hope to see you then. Bye for now.